go down the shore?
I don't know. It might be working.
Thank you.
Set the pace here. A little bit of a control duel going on here. They seem to control the ball. The Americans, typically a fast break team, adopted kind of a Lakers style of play. The Canadians definitely have the advantage in today's game because we're using one of their balls. You and I, Dick, I think we represent the two lone USA spectators this afternoon. Seems to be that way.
Just rebellious young youth. Helping out with the water earlier. I think the mother's now trying to go.
The young Canadians are more apt to play the faster-paced game that the Americans play rather than the controlled Canadian version. That's why you see many Canadian youths flock to the American universities to play collegiate lacrosse. Ooh, that one got away from him. Well, it's been everything you could always want in a box lacrosse match and more. Is that a Canadian down? Obviously can't take the physical abuse that the Americans are dishing out at this point. There goes another one! Oh. That's it. The Canadians are dropping like flies here. I think the third period's going to tell the story here, Dick. And the Americans have been able to hang so far. Here's our color man coming up to the booth.
Hey, Chris Willard joins us here in the seventh. Wills, what do you think about the Philadelphia team?
You don't know?
Hey, he's not the best color man for in the league for nothing.
Oh, Vince blew an opportunity.
My dad sent on you.
Oh, yeah?
Vince Kalamoska must have changed his shorts between periods.
I've noticed that.
Vince had the blue and green shorts on earlier, now he's switched over to khaki.
Weaving in and out, looking for Kalamoska. Kalamoska's double covered, hit from behind that.
I guess the Canadians realized the potential threat of a player like Vince.
They do. He's been quiet. He had two shots on goal in the first period.
Vince has been very quiet. That would attribute to the triple teams the Canadians have applied to him. Oh, save. Very nice save by our goalie Frank.
Did you tape last night's game?
Yes, sir. We were here last night, and we'll be here tomorrow.
That was an awesome game, man.
In town for a 3-day stand. And that'll end the second period.
Well, what's the score?
Wheels, do you know the score, Wheels?
What?
What's the score, Wheels?
I don't know.
10-4? The score at the end of the second period, 10-4.
10-4 as far as we know.
Not that it matters. We'll be back after this word from Toshiba. Able office equipment, that's 748-2014. We'd also like to thank WatchGuard Security Systems for...
WatchGuard, the first name in home protection. For your home, office, or car.
Export A is with us today. I'd like to also thank Blacks
Photography and all the lovely cameramen
and
Barbara, the left field ball girl.
We'd also like to thank all the Blacks for all their contributions to the box lacrosse. Well, we don't see very many Blacks in the league, but there is a swell in Southern Africa to play lacrosse.
And far that away, box lacrosse will become the national sport.
We'd also like to thank Beckers.
Beckers for that great name in science.
Once again, Coca-Cola.
Coke adds life.
Who else would we like to thank?
Shell.
Dick? Shell. We'd like to thank Cooperall.
Cooperall, first name in box lacrosse hockey equipment. Helmet, shoulder pads.
We'd like to thank Beehive, golden corn syrup.
Yummy, yummy.
There's been more than a beehive that I'd like on my pancakes.
I'm pretty sure the Washington team really appreciate the commercials, right?
Commercials are...
No yellow pages, whether it be gas, coke, WatchGuard security systems, or Toshiba home office equipment. You'll find it in the yellow pages. Got the munchies on your mind? Hostess.
I've got the munchies on my mind, Dick. I'd like to thank 649 and 649.
Now it's them, the daily.
The voice.
Our senior citizen.
Of the Philadelphia Box Across.
Our senior citizen. Michelle Wright's on board.
We're wondering to see who's holding that lucky ticket stub. That announcement will be coming up soon, so stay tuned, folks. There's is another lucky fan. Happy to be here in Peterborough, Ontario.
Attendance here tonight, 27.
27 in attendance?
That's not 27,000, that's 27. Let's get an accurate count on the attendance.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 15, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30.
There must be at least 45 people here tonight.
We'd also like to add while we have the time that for every goal Vince Kalamoska scores, the Eagles Fly for Leukemia Fund will donate $1 million to every local charity ever invented. So that can go a long way, Vince. We're counting on your goal.
Let's get a closer shot of Kalamoska.
We know what hasn't happened thus far.
Vince Kalamoska or O'Hara? Stand out. We have a shot at Vince Kalamoska, Cardinal O'Hara product. Standout academic scholar there, O'Hara, graduated from 4,962 students in 1985. Favorite subject was math.
What's up, dudes?
Presently works at Bennigan's, where he's a waiter. Average salary is about $550 a week. Vince is the all-time record for highest score in algebra class, sister of Mary Louise Elephant, his sophomore year.
He's got that 98 on algebra 2 class.
Yeah. Now scoring a perfect 100 in algebra 1.
Vince wears number 23 in honor of his favorite player. That being...
Let's talk about famous number 23s, other than Vince Kalamoska.
Vince is sort of the trademark number 23. When you associate the number 23, you do associate it with Vince Kalamoska.
Yeah, there's a lot of kids. I saw some of the little kids over there earlier in the day playing, and hey, throw it to me, I'm number 23. I'm number 23.
Vince wasn't going to be able to make this trip due to a urinary infection.
Well, he got some penicillin in.
Some vitamin E tablets, and he's all right so far. Vince looks a little tired, though, but has persevered these first two games.
Vince has promised us to take us to strip bars in Toronto. It's not delivered. Have you seen a bare breast?
I have not seen a bare breast since I've been in Peterborough.
No, I've looked at 16-year-old girl breasts. It's my utter dismay. Found that I've never seen them.
Hopefully we'll see a little bit of Toronto this evening.
Toronto, the bare breast there. A lot of people don't know this, but Breyer's Ice Cream originated in Toronto.
I'm going to have to disagree with you, Dick. Breyer's Ice Cream originated in Philadelphia. Home of the Philadelphia Box Lacrosse League and home of our Philadelphia Box Lacrosse teams.
Here comes Dan. Oh, we got one of the players in the booth. Let's get an interview with him. This is Dan.
How you doing?
Dan, we're talking about the C word, capitalization. Give me your thoughts on capitalizing the Canadians' mistakes. What do you think the main...
Well, mistakes should never be capitalized, seeing as how it's not a proper noun.
What's your name again?
This man obviously goes to Penn State University.
Penn State University English major. Well, I do. Teacher in the future lacrosse. Hey,
oh, yeah, bend over.
What is the score?
10-4.
10-4?
What?
Our color commentator came up and told us what the score was. It's just pandemonium here on the court. Time for the junior box across championships.
There's the sound in the start of the third.
The start of the third period, which is really going to tell the tale here.
Back here at Peterborough Memorial Coliseum.
Coming up at Peterborough Memorial Coliseum, we do have...
I'd like to take this time to remind everybody... Although we can't see it very well, Kenny Rogers will be here on July 8th. And...
The crowd home of the Petersburg Fingers Skating Hall since 1956.
You're listening to the voices of the Philadelphia Box Lacrosse League.
Jim Whittemer and
Mike Fletcher, who we refer to in the business as Dick.
Dick Vitale will be joining us later in the night for the exciting conclusion of the second game here of the Canadian Philadelphia World Championships. The Amateur World Championships.
Seems to be a little trouble with the court. Need to close the door. And with the doors closed, ready to
start the third period. I think you can just say that. A lot of people say who wins the faceoff in the third period sometimes is who will win the third period. A lot of people say who won the third period is who will win the game. Let's hope that's true. Kind of a nonchalant beginning. Oh, there's pounding. Frustration on the game.
Looks like the Americans are trying to set you. Oh!
Bagel, baby!
Big goal.
That's a big goal.
That brings the score to 10-5.
10-5. The Americans exploding here at the opening of the third period. I think that's going to wake up the Canadians.
I think the Canadians might have taken this American team a little too lightly after that trouncing 27-1 victory last
evening. Just call the Canadians 5 for 6, baby. Got to play 6 periods over 2 days. Can only handle 5. Last period, can't handle it. They're falling asleep out there. Well, you admit it, you remember that.
The Americans thus far dominating him. I don't think a Canadian has touched the ball. Kill him, crush him into the boards. Tonight's referees are Rick Moranis and Bob Thomas, formerly of SCTV.
You might have seen him in the Star movie, The Great White North.
1982 release.
I really can't see why that didn't get an Academy Award, Dick.
All-time most popular Canadian film, grossing $164 billion in its first run release. A lot of people have talked about a sequel to that film. Something to do with box lacrosse, actually.
A much-awaited sequel, actually.
Lacrosse being the national sport of the Great White North. Look at that. That is a blown opportunity on the Canadians' part. Dominating the first. Number 12 firing up court. Number 10. Penn State man who corrected us on our misuse of the English language.
Oh, beautiful save by Frank, Team USA goalie. The average age of this Canadian team is somewhere in the vicinity of 39 years old.
Where the Americans a mere 22. 21. Vince Kalamaska beefs up the average age since he is 43. Father of 7.
Goal.
Residents of the Springfield area.
Here's an update on the Vince Kalamaska shorts epic. Vince still wearing those khaki shorts.
And coming into the game.
We're unsure why he changed the black and green neon shorts that he was wearing in the first period.
Which I think were more attractive. You know, Vince's 5-year-old daughter, Sally Kalamaska, has a birthday coming up at the end of the week. Vince went off to Israel after this for the Universal Championship of box lacrosse. It was at the Intercontinental.
He'll take on the Matzo squad.
Intercontinental champion of the world, box lacrosse.
Ball still on the ground.
Guy has no helmet on. Number 10 has no helmet on.
Y.A. Tittle in the game now. And out of play. That'll be black ball.
Remember, Blacks is the first name in photography.
We'd like to thank Blacks, the first name in photography. Oh, nice
Fish
shot taken
and
there.
And stone off him.
So
oh,
breakaway.
Frank's ready for this. And he was.
Let
me get a shot of the blonde down
Frank,
there.
Who has had to handle an overall barrage of shots today. An all-out assault on the American team.
A lot of talk about steroid uses and drug testing in amateur lacrosse.
Once again, I would like to remind you folks out there that the trade rumors of trading Vince Calamasca to the New Zealand team has been disqualified by Vince signing a new one-year
$5 million, making him the highest-paid athlete, beating Jose Canseco by over $10,000. Let me talk to you for a second, Joe. I was talking to Vince earlier in the week, and he told me that he wasn't going to leave Philadelphia, and one of the main reasons was family. Vince is a big family man.
Vince is a big family man.
Seven kids. You know, Vince had an opportunity to play on the Olympic team in 1972, and he opted not to. The reason was...